वक्रतुंड घाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्लव निर्विघ्नं कुरुमे देव सर्वकार्यसु दासरस्तिर्वस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाव्य संपृक्तौ वागर्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरो येनाक्षर समाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्सुबन्ताधिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमाभाग्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं भिन्नापुस्तकधारिणीं वेदाञ्जाढ्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां नत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोमि पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदीम्। सो वी वेर एट दी ग्रामणी शब्द व्हाट वी सॉ अर्लियर वाज प्रदीहि। सो इन कंटिन्यूएशन सिमिलर टू प्रदी शब्द इज ग्रामणी शब्द से लघुकार से एवं ग्रामणी ही। व्हाट इज ग्रामणी? ग्रामं नयति इति ग्रामणी। द लीडर ऑफ द ग्राम इन पुल्लिंग इज कॉल्ड एज ग्रामणी ही। सो ग्राम प्लस नीज प्रापणे धातु देर नीज प्रापणे धातु एंड देन क्विप क्विप इज एडेड कर्तरी क्विप देर नाम प्लस नी रिमेन्स एंड देन यू गेट ग्रामणी विथ नत्वम अग्र ग्रामाभ्याम नयतीर्णो वाच्यः। सो देर इज सम नत्वम देर एंड इन सेवेंथ केस सिंगुलर न्यौ तु ग्रामण्याम यू गेट ग्रामण्यम बाय ज्ञेर ज्ञेराम नद्याम नीभ्यः। सो नी धातु इज स्पेसिफिकली मेन्शन बाय नीभ्यः देर देर फोर न्यौ ज्ञेहे ज्ञेहे आम। सो आम इज द आदेश देर एंड यू विल गेट ग्रामण्याम। सो दैट इज द सेवेंथ केस सिंगुलर फॉर्म वेर देर इज अ चेंज। फर्दर वॉट अनेकाच किम इन दी सूत्र वॉट हैज बीन सेड इफ यू लुक एट द सूत्र एर अनेकाच असंयुग पूर्वस्य अंगस्य यण धातो हो अचि। सो वी हैव सीन द हायरार्की इज फर्स्ट देर इज अ इको यण ची यण देन दैट इज निगेटेड बाय इयंग वंग आदेशस देन देर इज यण अगेन बाय एर अनेकाच असंयुग पूर्वस्य इत्यादि देन समटाइम्स देर इज अ पार्ट अपवाद टू दिस यण एंड इयंग अंग कैन कम बैक। सो वॉट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर इज दैट ईदर यू विल गेट इयंग उवंग मीनिंग इय उव काइंड ऑफ फॉर्म्स और यू विल गेट यकार वकार इन द फॉर्म बाय एंड यू विल गेट यकार वकार एंड बाय इयंग उंग यू विल गेट इय और उव। सो दीज आर द फॉर्म्स दैट यू विल गेट इय और उव। सो इफ दैट इज फॉर एक्यूरेसी विच सूत्र वी हैव टू लुक अप बट एज लॉन्ग एज वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू विल गेट ईदर यण और इय उव देन द फॉर्म्स आर इजीली अंडरस्टूड। अनेकाच किम सो वाय अनेकाच हैज बीन यूज अनेकाच मीन्स मेनी अच्स आर देर इन दी धातु। सो नी ही किम नी ही। सो हियर नी धातु देर इट कंसिस्ट ओनली अंगा कंसिस्ट ओनली वन वॉवेल वन अच। सो देन वॉट वेन अंगा कंटेन्स ओनली वन अच मीन अनेकाच इट इज नॉट देन वॉट देन यण बाय अनेर अनेकाच एर अनेकाचो असंयुग पूर्व से डज नॉट अप्लाई बिकॉज यू मे हैव दी अंगा विच इज वॉट असंयुग पूर्व ऑल राइट बट there is no sanyoga in knee obviously there is no sanyoga there is only one consonant and one ikara in the anga so the knee dhatu has as an anga has only one nakara and ikara there is no sanyoga there only varna milana is there so although we have asanyoga purva but anekacha is not there so if it is not anekacha then the this sutra won't apply and then yan is negated partly by this iyang so you will get achishnu dhatu bhuvam your iyang vango thereby iyang will come in so iya is the adesha and not yakara by yan therefore what will you get this was a ni was an example used there so this ni what will happen iyo so this ikara is replaced by not by yan but you will get iya and then au प्रथमा द्विवचन द्वितीय द्विवचन फॉर्म्स यू विल गेट एज नकार इय एंड देन औ नियौ नियः। and so on in the jus form also. So the explanation is given here, ni plus au, what will happen? Achishnu dhatu bhruvam, your yango angu will apply, because this ni dhatu is what? Not anekach, it is ekach, therefore niyau, niyaha ityadi. Similarly with what? Niyam, niyaha ityadi. Niyam sutra, niyam you will get when this ni sthana, nyakara itsthana ityadi, you will get niyam, niyam, niyam in the saptami. Ekvachana, this is the form niyam. Then the asamiga purvasya kim. So what is the meaning, I mean, why did the sutra vritti use asamiga purvasya sutra or sutra vritti? Why is there asamiga purva word used in the sutra? So meaning what? Asamiga purva means there should be no conjunct consonant earlier. In ni it wasn't there, but it was not anekach, it was ekachanga. Now you have to take an exception to this, as in anekach should be valid, but asanyuga purva should not be valid. That is an example for asanyuga purvasya kim. So there anekachah anga is what? This sushriya, sushri, sushri. There this asanyuga purva, anekach sushri. If you look at it, it is an anga which has multiple vowels. Ukara is there, ikara is also there. Therefore, it is sushri. So this anga here, sushri. So this sushri anga, it has two vowels, therefore it is anekach. So anekach anga it is, therefore a anekach should apply, but a anekach ityadi. But asanyuga purva se it is not. Meaning what? It is sanyuga purva. This anga has shra, this ikara is preceded by shakara and repha. Then there is ikara. So this ikara is preceded by a sanyoga. So this ikara will be what? This ikara will be called as sanyoga purva ikara. It is not asanyoga purva. Therefore, this sutra won't apply. And then what will you get? You will get the form as what? When you decline, you will get iyanguvam instead of yan. So you will get sushriyaha, sushriyau ityadi. So there will be iyang instead of yang, yan adesha. Then shuddha dhihi example is taken here. Shuddha dhihi. So shuddha dhihi yasya sa shuddha dhihi. One who has shuddha buddhi will be called as shuddha dhihi. And this is a bahuri samasa. So here if you look at this, there are multiple ways to derive this. But what is shown here is that this shuddha dhihi yasya, once you get this shuddha dhihi shabda, how will it decline? For nadi sanya, there is a nisheda sutra. Na yanguang sthanav astri yu striyakhyo. So nadi sanya is negated, so it is negated by this sutra, the 144. So what does it say is that the word ending with ivarna uvarna, which is subject to yanguam, so yanguam sthana are those words which can take yanguam, those are called as yanguam sthana, those kind of shabdas. So yu striyakhyo astri, except for stri shabda, those words are not considered as nadi sanyaka. So this is a nisheda sutra for nadi sanya. So shuddha dhi, since shuddha dhi takes yang uang, yang adesha, uang adesha, not uang, but since ikaranta, it will take yang adesha. So therefore it is what? Yang uang sthana. And yang uang sthana, this shuddha dhi will not get nadi sanya. If it does not get nadi sanya, then it will not decline like nadi shabda. Not nadi shabda, nadi sanyaka shabdas. So gatishcha, what will happen here in that case? Now here this shuddha dhi yasya, that is shuddha dhi, it's a bahuri. So the dhi and shuddha, the connection that you see is different in the case of what follows. Now you get pradaya kriya yoge gati sanyasthu. Where will there be a gati sanya? Gati sanya is when the pradi gana 22 terms which are mentioned there in the pradi gana, when they have kriya yoga with the dhatu in the shabda that follows, then meaning there is a anvaya possible, then that kind of a pradi will get the gati sanya. or upasarga sanya in some cases. There is a vartika there. Gatikaraka itara purvapadasi yan neshyate. Why is this needed? Because if there is a gati sanya, then one behavior. If there is no gati sanya, then another behavior. Similarly for karaka. If the karaka sanya is there, meaning not a karaka sanya, karaka is present, then one behavior. If karaka is not present in the purvapada, then another behavior. So what is it saying? Vartika says, gati karaka itara purvapadasi yan naishyate. There won't be yan if the purvapada is different from gati and karaka, gati or karaka. So what I said, gati karaka itara purvapadasi yan naishyate, meaning, where is samasa? So gati karaka itarat, gati kar itarat purvapadam yasya tad gati karaka itara purvapadam anga. So tasya angasya, the anga which does not have which is different, which has a purvapada which is different from gati and karaka. So now we have to see whether this in the shuddha dhi is there, the purvapada is shuddha, shuddha dhiyasya, that shuddha shabda, is it gati or karaka, or is it different from gati or karaka? That has to be analyzed for to see how shuddha dhi is declined. Okay, it is not nadi shabda, it is not nadi sanyaka. But still, even if it is not nadi sanyaka, you still have to see whether yan will apply or iyang will apply. For that purpose, you have to see whether the purvapada shuddha is gati or gati karaka itarata. So now it says that in the word shuddhadi, the purvapada shuddha, which is other than gati or karaka. So it is itara from the gati or karaka. Shuddha is not a gati, not a karaka. Thereby, what has happened is that thus thereby yan is negated by the vartika. The vartika negates yan. Yan naishyate. Yan naishyate has been mentioned. Therefore, this shuddha shabda which is there in shuddhadhi is shuddhadhi purvapada. This is a purvapada which is neither gati nor karaka. It is neither gati nor karaka. Therefore, yan naishyate. Yan will not apply. So yand sandhi will not apply. So what will happen if yand does not apply? Obviously it will go to what? Iyang adesha. Thereby you will get shuddha dhiyo ityadi form. So instead of yand, you will get iya. That is all it means. So but you will need too many sutras and vartikas. The difference is only simple. Either you will get yand or you get iya. That's all. In austana etc. it is very clear to see. Okay. So then you'll take the, instead of shuddha dhi, the word taken is sudhi. Now in sudhi, what is happening? Sudhi, su meaning has shushtu. Shushtu is similar to shuddha, but the word is clearly different, shushtu or shobana. Now here, multiple kinds of vrittis are possible. Here one vritti considered is shushtu jhayati iti sudhihi. So shushtu jhayati, if you say, then what will happen? This shushtu, su is a pradi. Initially, Shru is a Pradigana entity, Su, meaning is Sushtu. So, Sushtu, but Dhyai Chintayam Dhatu, which is following, and thereby becomes Dhihi Shabda, there Upapada Tatpurusha is made. If you make Upapada Tatpurusha, then Sushtu is qualifying the Dhyana. Dhyayati. Dhyanam, Sushtu Yatha Bhavati Tata Dhyayati, that kind of a meaning comes in. There is a then anvaya possible. So this sushtu has kriya yoga with dhyai dhyayati. So this dhyai chintayam dhatu within this dhi shabda, hidden in this dhi shabda is what? Dhyayati. Kartari yutpati is there. So that kartari is qualified by sushtu. Meaning how does he do dhyana? Sushtu. So sushtu dhyayati. Thereby there is anvaya there. There is kriya yoga. And thereby what will happen? This will get the due to this gati, it will get gati sanya, because kriya yoga is there, it will get gati sanya upasarga, and thereby sudhihi in this shabda, this will behave different from what you expect, a behavior different from shuddhadi. So you expect it. What has happened here yang vam, but what has happened here? Sushtu dhyayati. What will happen here? You expect this, but sudhi, once you get sudhi, this sudhi shabda, being sudhi shabda yand, here aneka achaha asamiga purvasi is what you expect, but then it is negated by na bhus sudhi yoho. You expect this, but why do you don't get this form? Again, as I said, this entire table is misplaced here. you cannot get this table, it should go after the nabhu sudhiyoho. Otherwise you will get what? You will get yand. You are expecting a yand because it's getting a gati sanya. Now nisheda sutra is there. The nisheda sutra says nabhu sudhiyoho yand supi achi. So yand na, yand will not take place. When it will not take place? When you have bhu or sudhi. So sudhi shabda itself is mentioned there. Therefore, although we expect an yand, it will be prohibited by this sutra, and then again it will go back to iyanguangadesha, and then you will get sudhiyo ityadi. You will get iya form, not ya, yakara form. Then sukhi suti shabda, sukham ichchati iti sukhihi. So one who desires sukha is called as sukhihi in that kind of a yutpatti. So what is this here? Sukhiya is the namadhatu. Sukhiya. How do you get this? By kyach pratya, supa atmana kyach. So kyach pratya is added in the when somebody expects something for atmana. This is atma here is reflexive for oneself. So when one expects something for oneself, then kyach pratya is added after the supaha. So this subanta shabda, this supaha dhatu pratiparika look will take place after sukha plus plus kyach. So sukham ichchati, in that meaning you'll get sukha plus in dvitiya. So this is a dvitiya ekvachana, and kyach pratya to say that one desires for oneself. Then what will happen? This sukha plus kyach, there will go away, you'll have sukha plus kyach. Content of it is a kit and a chit pratya, you will get ya. Sukhiya is a new dhatu by sanadyantaha dhatava. Sanadi pratya, kyach is sanadi pratya, and then sanadi anta, kyach is sanadi, which is at anta of this pratipadika. You will get dhatu sanya, not pratipadika, it will get dhatu sanya. Sanadyanta dhatava. Then now sukhiya plus quip. How do you get this sukhiya plus quip? This quip pratya is a zero pratya. Nothing will remain. Veya prukta se ityari will apply. And then what will happen is that this sukhi shabda is derived now. This is all not needed here. But how do you decline sukhi now? After you get sukhi, in the meaning of what? Sukham ichchati. One desire sukha. For oneself obviously. Then sukhi, when you are declining, what happens? Here it is said that anekachaha asanyuga purvasya will apply, and then you will get what? And this e kara with au, there will be yand sandhi. Why? Because this sukhi shabda is anekacha, ukara, e kara, two achs are there, anekacha, and asanyuga purvasya, before this e kara, there is a khakara. Khakara is a single letter, there is no consonant, conjunction. So there is no conjunct consonant, therefore asanyuga purva anekacha e will get what? Yand. So there will be yand, and yand will give you sukhya. Sukhya plus o, you'll get sukhya vityadi. So then obviously everywhere there will be yand instead of yavo. So that's how you'll get this sukhya, sukhye, sukhyu vityadi forms. Other bhyam places are not important because you just add them. Sukhi, sukhi bhyam, sukhi bhi, sukhi bhya, sukhi su, and then there will be a murdhanya by sukhishu, and then you will get sukhishu by inko ityadi. Dhatu apadantasya sakarasya murdhanya inkoho, and what is that? It is adesha pratyayoho. Adesha pratyayoho is the sutra there. You will get murdhanya adesha sakara, apadanta sakara will become shanmukh sakara. We are more interested in what happens in the sthana where vowel is at the beginning of the pratya, whether you will get yand or whether you will get iya or uvangadesha. Uvang win ukaranta or ukaranta. So let's look at those now. He'll answer shambhu and kroshtu. So now shambhu is like hari, shambhu harivat. But all that is going to come up later, in fact. It is taken here. But then what is the meaning of shambhu harivat? Actually this can be questionable. How can shambhu decline like hari? When you are studying without sutra, shambhu is definitely not like hari. Completely ukaranta, ikaranta are completely different. But when you are studying with sutras, what is being said is that sutra wise, when you use sutras, then yand includes what happens to ikara and also to ukara. So ikara will go to what? Ikara will take yakara yanadesha. Ukara will take vakara by yanadesha. Therefore, sutra wise, yan will be sandhi. Wherever yan has taken place for hari, there yanadesha will take place for shambhua also. Therefore, instead of yakara, you will get vakara. That's all it means by saying shambhu hari vatu. Yan is the common between hari and shambhu shabda. But outside of the sutras, hari and shambhu are totally different words. So that's what it means, and thereby you know shambhu start with shambhu and then shambhu shambhavaha. Wherever dirgha was there, again dirgha will take place. Hari he had become hari, so shambhu will become shambhu or guru shabda. Elsewhere we see guru shabda, and wherever yan has taken place or hoy has taken place, that will take place as well shambhavaha. Then guna, where it has taken place in sambuddhi, hari had become hare. Shambhu ukara will become okara by guna. So that guna will also apply. So yan. So what we are seeing is sutra wise yan, echo yavayavaha, yava, echo yavayavaha, or what? Or guna, or dirgha. So which are taking place? These four things are common. Yan, one, echo yavaha, two, three, guna, fourth, dirgha, whatever order you consider it, those are taking place in the same sthanas wherever they occurred in Hari Shabda. Similarly, they'll occur in Guru or Shambhu Shabda. So you'll get Shambhu Ityadi, such kind of Shambhu. Then here also, you got whatever was the sutra applying, same sutras are applying here as well. Considering that it is going to take a single form. And akara or aukara, what you see, however it has taken place, that same thing will apply here as well. Evam bhanu adaya, bhanu, guru, ityadi will also be in the same manner. Now, rukaranta shabda, interestingly, to bridge the gap from ukaranta to rukaranta, what lagukara does, he takes a shabda which sometimes behaves like rukaranta in some forms it behaves like ukaranta or like both. So, that kind of a shabda he picks up, which is a rare shabda to have a look at, but it is considered that by Lagukara considers this shabda because it bridges the gap. It uses ukara kind of forms also and rukara also. So he is jumping from ukara to rukara or vice versa by looking at, if you look at the order in the book, then Trijuvat Kroshtuhu. So Kroshtu shabda, Kroshtu means Shurgala, jackal. A jackal shabda, that meaning is jackal. It is basically ukaranta, but trijuvata. Trijuvata means as though it is trijanta shabda. Trijanta shabda is what trich pratyay is a, will give you a krudanta shabda. So krudanta shabda like kartru. Krudhatu plus trich will give you kartru. The kartru, how kartru declines, kartru is trich shabda, trijanta shabda, trijanta vat. So trijuvata means trijanta vat kroshtu shabda. The kroshtu should be treated like a trijanta shabda, and then this kroshtu will become as though it is Kroshtru. Ukaranta, instead of Ukaranta, will become Rukaranta really. Then, when Asambuddhav Sarvanamasthani. So, when not in Sambuddhi. Sambuddhi is what? Prathama Ekvachana Sambodhana. So, non-Sambuddhi Ekvachana and then Sarvanamasthana. There should be Sarvanamasthana Pratyaya following. Sambuddhi is also Sarvanamasthana, but it should not be Sambuddhi. That kind of a Sarvanamasthana Pratyaya following, then what will happen? Then this Kroshtu Ukaranta Shabda will behave Trijantavat, meaning it will behave like Rukaranta. So Kroshtu Shabda will become Kroshtru. So Kroshtu plus Su, there Kroshtru, Kroshtu plus Su will become Kroshtu plus Su. So this Ukara has become Rukara as though. So you replace that as Kroshtru. Then what happens? Then Ruto Nisarvanamasthanayoho Angasya Gunaha. So Anga will take Guna Rutaha. Rutaha Rudantas Rudantat. It is Shashti Ekvachana, so not Rudantat. Rudantasya. So Rudantasya, this Rudantasya Shashti. Yeah, so Rudantasya Angasya. Ni Sarvanamasthani. So Ni Sarvanamasthana. Either it should be Ni or Sarvanamasthana Pratyaya following. So Ni Saptami Ekvachana. And Sarvanamasthana are all these Sudanapunsakasya. So Sut. So in the Sutsthana or when Ni follows this Rudantanga, then Rudantanga will take Guna. So Rukara will take Guna, it will become A. So A will be the Adesha. And then after A, what? Urandrapara. Uran पूरण र परह हैज टू बी अप्लाइड वेन एवर देर इज अ रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ रू विथ अ. सो वॉट विल हैपन विथ हियर क्रोष्ट्रु प्लस सकारा हियर अनदर थिंग इज हैपनिंग हियर नथिंग हैज बीन डिराइव्ड हियर यू नीड सम मोर सो गुणा हैज टू टेक प्लेस इज प्राप्त ओके गुणा इज प्राप्त बट वॉट हैपन्स देर इज एन अपवाद सूत्र रुत उशनस पुरुदं सह अनेहसांच अनंसौ असंबुद्धौ. सो व्हाट इट सेज दैट देर इज अनंसौ अनंग सौ सो सु सु असंबुद्धौ दिस सौ असंबुद्धौ इज सप्तमी एकवचन सो सु विच इज नॉट इन संबुद्धि मीनिंग व्हाट नॉन संबोधन प्रथम मीनिंग प्रथम प्रथमा एकवचन विच इज नॉट संबोधन देन वॉट विल हैपन अनंग अनंग इज द आदेश न्यकार इज इन इट सो अन इज द आदेश फॉर रुच वॉट विल हैपन हियर नाउ एंड वॉट एल्स इज सेज या एंड देन वी आर लुकिंग एट रुजंता बट अदर शब्द उशनस पुरुदंसस एंड अनेहस आर ऑल्सो मेन्शन दे विल ऑल्सो वेन सू इज नॉट इन संबुद्धि फॉलोइंग देन अनंग इज द आदेश फॉर दीज शब्द ऑल्सो अवर इंटरेस्ट इज करेंटली इन रुच हियर रुदंता सो वॉट विल हैपन क्रोष्टु हैज बिकम क्रोष्ट्रु देन although you are expecting guna kroshtru ru should have become akara and then urandrapara should have applied but what will happen there is a specific apavada ru is mentioned there therefore rudanta rudanta will get ana so ana here anang so right anang so the anang here this will should be anang so an is the adesha an adesha will take place and then you will get what it is agnita adesha agnitya so generally what if there is a single letter then alontyasya then what do you have anekal shit sarvasya if it is anekal or shit then the adesha should go to the entire sthani the sthani is the entire word it is not the last letter so here that is prapta but it because the adesha anang is having multiple letters even if you take away nyakara and akara an an has two letters therefore is multi letter anekal should take away the entire sthani but nichya says alontyasya brings back alontyasya nichya alontyasya only the last letter is replaced so your last letter is rukara that rukara is replaced by an then you will get kroshtan kroshtan plus sakara now this su sakara what will happen here now so currently nothing meaning the expected sutra will be applied later but one more karya is remaining this upada dirgha this akara should become dirgha for that next sutra is read by laghukara which is a vidhi sutra he says aktrun trach swasru naktru neshtru twashtru shatru hotru potru prashastruna upadayah dirgha asambuddho sarvanamasthane the sutra is only this much त्रिणाम प्रशास्त्रुणाम एंडिंग विथ प्रशास्त्रुणाम उपदा दीर्घ टेक्स प्लेस बट हियर व्हाट इज अवर इंटरेस्ट हियर अप्त्रुन एंड त्रुच सो अप्त्रुन एंड त्रुच सो त्रुच त्रुच एंडिंग शब्द बिकॉज त्रिजुवत वी हैव त्रिजुवत त्रिजुवत इज द क्रोष्टु शब्द देयरफॉर दिस त्रिजुवत विल कॉज द क्रोष्टु शब्द विच इज इन क्रोष्टु ऑल्सो टू टेक दिस आदेश ऑल्दो इट हैज बिकम क्रोष्टन नाउ The Kroshtan will take Upada Dhirga. It will become what? Kroshtan. Kroshtan plus Sa. So you will get Kroshtan plus Sa now. This is where we are. Kroshtan plus Sa. After this, Aptrun Trach. So this is our Sutra. Now what happens is Sakara Hal Niyabhyo Dhirga Sutisya Pruktam Hal Lopaha Lupyate. This Sakara will go away. So you will get with Kroshtan. Now what will happen? This Nakara is at the end of the Pada because this is a Su has been applied. This is a Pada. सुप्तिंगंतम पदम देन दिस पदांत नकार विच इज प्रातिपादिक प्रातिपदिकांत नकार दैट विल गो अवे बाय नलोप ऑफ प्रातिपदिकांतस्य पदस्य पदांतस्य पदस्य पदांतस्य द पदांत नकार विच इज प्रातिपदिकांत नकार बिकॉज दिस अन हैज बीन एन आदेश फॉर क्रोष्टु शब्द क्रोष्टु विच हैज बिकम क्रोष्टु दैट इटसेल्फ टुक द अनादेश सो प्रातिपदिक इज दिस नकारांत Now it has become pada, which is also nakaranta. Both being the same, they will be dropped. The nakara will be dropped, and you will get kroshtra. So what will happen? Kroshtan. Now krosh, sorry, kroshta, not kroshtra, kroshta. So kroshta is the Rupa Siddhi here. Kroshta, Kroshtaro, Kroshtara Ityadi, it will decline in that manner. All these sutras remain same. What happens here, Kroshtarha, Kroshta, Kroshtaro, Kroshtara Ityadi, in then what will happen in the Sarvanamasthana is being over in Sud. Sud only first five are included. So when you come outside the first five, in Dvitiya Bahuvachana is the sixth form. So there what happens? Kroshtun. Why? Sarvanamasthana is over. Trijyot Bhava is only for Sarvanamasthana, Pratyaya following. So 2-3 is not, it is what? Asarvanamasthana. Being Asarvanamasthana, this Pratyaya will not cause Trijyot Bhava. So if it is not Trijyot Bhava, the Trijyot Kroshtu will not apply. And then Kroshtu Shabda itself will take Dirgha, Ukara. So what will happen? Kroshtu Shabda has never become Trijanta. Trijvat it has not become. So Kroshtu Ukara Prathame Purva Savarna Dirgha. Dirgha Kroshtu Ukara itself will become Kroshtus. And then the Shas Kroshtus, it will become Kroshtus. And this Prathame Dirgha Eka Pura, this Akara here and this Ukara here, both together are replaced by Ekaha Purva Parayoho Dirgha. So U and A together will be replaced by Dirgha of the Purva Savarna. Purva Savarna Dirgha, Ukara will become Ukara, you will get Kroshtus. Then what will happen? Tasmat Shaso Navpumsi. After this Purva Savarna Dirgha, Tasmat Shasoho. When Shas Pratyaya follows, then what will happen? Shasaha Navpumsi. Shasaha, not Shasaha, it is a Sthani. So Shasaha Nah Nakaraha Adesha Hoti. So Us will become Shas. There is no Us. Akara is gone. So Tasmat Dirghat. Tasmat Purva Savarna Dirghat. The Purva Savarna Dirgha, Ukara and Akara has become Ukara and Ukara Dirgha. That Ukara, which has replaced Ukara and Akara both together, this, it will be what? It will be considered as Shas, the first letter of Shas also, and the last letter of Kroshtu also. Because the Ekadesha is considered as Purvasya Antavat and what is following? Parasya Adivat. So Ekadesha is what? Ekadesha is equal to. Ekadesha is equal to what? Purvasya. Purvapadasya. Purvasya. What was replaced? Not Purvapadasya. Purvasya Aksharasya. Purvasya Antavat. It will be like the ending letter of the earlier. Meaning of the Kroshtu. This Ukara. This Purvasavarna. Ekaha Adesha, which is Purvasavarna Dirgha. So Ukara, which has been Ekadesha Ukara, this Ukara is considered as Purvasya Antavat, meaning it is what? The last letter of Kroshtu, and it will also be considered as Parasya Adivat. So it is considered as the first letter of the Para. Para is Shas, so which is the content is Us. So this Us, the Ukara is the first letter of Us. So now what will happen? Tasmat Shaso, after that, this Shas itself. Ukara is part of Shas, so that Us is actually Shas. So Usaha, Shasaha, Usaha, Na, Naha, Pumsi. In Pullinga, we are doing Pullinga. So in Pullinga, what will happen? There will be Nakara Adesha, and this Sakara will be replaced by Nakara. Alontyasya will apply, you will get Kroshtun. So this is the Rupa Siddhi of Dvitiya Bahuvachana. This is needed because in Dhatru Shabda also, we'll go to Dhatrun. Dirga. Now there is a vibhasha. As I said, there are trujanta or non-trujanta, trujvat bhava or non-trujvat bhava. So trujvat bhava is optional by what? The next sutra, vidhi sutra, vibhasha tritiyadishvachi. So vibhasha means va trujvat bhava. So trujvat bhava is va. Trujvat va. So va is written there. So trujvat va meaning what? Either it will be Kroshtu Shabda, either it will be like Kroshtu Shabda, or it will be like Kroshtru. So you'll have two forms, that's all it means. It'll have two forms. Sorry. Okay, yeah. So it will have this Kroshtu Trich form is optional. Tritiyadishu, Achi. But only when what? Tritiyadishu, this Achi, third case onwards, but only when Ajadi Pratyaya follows. Achi means what? Ajado Pratyaya Pare. Ajado Supi Pratyaya Pare. You will get what? You will get these त्रिजवत भाव स्टार्टिंग विथ तृतीय और नॉन त्रिजवत भाव स्टार्टिंग विथ तृतीय विभक्ति. सो टा टा इज अ तृतीय प्रत्यय. सो तृतीय एक वचन वॉट हैव क्रोश टू प्लस टा एंड इट इज एन अजादि प्रत्यय. आफ्टर यू टेक अवे टकार वॉट यू हैव यू हैव आ प्रत्यय. इट इज एन अजादि प्रत्यय अची. सो देयर फॉर क्रोश टू प्लस आ और क्रोश टू प्लस आ बोथ फॉर्म्स आर देयर. सो इफ यू हैव क्रोश टू प्लस आ वॉट विल हैपन इट विल डिक्लाइन लाइक त्रिज त्रिजंत शब्द यू विल गेट क्रोस्ट्रा. इको एनर्जी विल टेक प्लेस यू विल गेट रू विल बी रिप्लेस बाय रेफा यू विल गेट क्रोस्ट्र यवर ल. सो यण यण आदेश इको एनर्जी क्रोस्ट्रा. सो दिस इज वन फॉर्म. अदरवाइज वॉट नॉट नॉन क्रुजत भाव. सो वॉट विल हैपन इन दी अदर ऑप्शन वॉट विल हैपन घी संज्ञा विल बी देर बाय शेषो घ्यसकी लाइक हरि शब्द. सो शेषोगी एंड लाइक हरि बिकम्स हरिणा here you get kroshtuna. So ango nastriyam will apply ghehe because it is a ghee sanyaka shabda ukaranta hraswa ukaranta it is non nadi and shesha it is it will get ghee sanya and then what will angha anga ang is ta ta pratyaya. So na so ta will be replaced by na astriyam since kroshtu is a non stri shabda you will get na and then kroshtuna. No natvam like hari obviously. So you will get because this 2 is there. Shakara would otherwise cause natvam. Here takara is there. Therefore takara will block the natvam. You will get kroshtuna. So this is the second form. So kroshtra also or kroshtuna. Next Vidhi Sutra is Ruta Ut. So what happens Ruta Ut? You need in what will happen in Nyasi Gnyaso. So Nyasi Gnyaso ho ati puro parivyo eka samhitayam. एक समित पूर्वपर विल गेट एक आदेश अचिपरे वेन दी अकार आदि न्यस और न्यसी प्रत्यय आर फॉलोइंग वॉट रुत रुदंत शब्द देन वॉट विल हैपन उत उकार तपरकरण इज एन उकार इज द आदेश. सो रू विल बिकम ऊ वेन इन पंचमी एक वचन षष्टी एक वचन पूर्वपरयो एक जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट. Yeah, so puro parve eka, so both together, not ru, ru and a, both together are replaced by a. So puro parve eka uta adesha. So what will you get? Kroshtu, trujvat, ru has, ru is the adesha. Then what will happen if you go further? Kroshtur. So what has happened? This rukara and akara together has been replaced by single ukara by ruta ut nyasig nyasoho. अति पूर्वपर एक संहिता. सो यू एक्सपेक्ट बिकॉज दिस अत इज ऑल्सो अची यू एक्सपेक्ट वॉट विभाषा तृतीयादिशु अची यू एक्सपेक्ट दिस त्रिजुवत भाव टू बी ऑप्शनल बट दिस ऑप्शनल इट शुड बी ऑप्शनल एंड नाउ इट इज वॉट रुत उत न्यसी न्यसु अति दिस अत इज वॉट अत सेज दैट इन दी अच देर इज एन अत. सो अची वॉज सेड अर्लियर दिस अची इन दिस अची अति. So akara nyasi and nyastana are where akara adi pratyaya is there. Thereby hu adesha will take place and you will get kroshtur. Kroshtur plus sa. Why? Because urandrapara will apply. Once this ruta ut ukara is a replacement for ru, then urandrapara will follow. Then u will be ur, will become ur. So kroshtur and the nyasi sakara is still there. You will get kroshturs. But then kanjang cannot be there. For that sanyogantasya lopa is prapta, but there is a specific qualification of that niyama sutra which says ratsasya. So rat repha uttarat, after the repha uttara sasya eva lopa natu anyasya, that's what it means. So sanyogantasya lopa means what? Anything else anything following, not anything else, any conjunct letter following any conjunct letter will undergo lopa at the end of the pada because padantasya antasya padanta sanyoga. If there is a padanta sanyoga, two conjuncts are put together, then the last letter should be dropped, second letter should be dropped, which is the last letter of the pada, a consonant, that should be dropped, lopaha. But what has been said, if the repha is at the second last position, then what should be dropped, the last conjunct in the consonant in the conjunct, that last or the second consonant after repha in the second last position should be dropped only if it is a sakara. If there is non-sakara, it should not be dropped. That's what it means. Therefore, you have a Niyamana Sutra which prohibits anything other than sakara after a repha at the end of the pada from being dropped. But here, what do you have? We have that scenario of repha and sakara. So, sakarasya, repha uttarasya, sakarasya, padantasya, sakarasya, lopaha ishyate. Thereby, it will be dropped and then you will get what? You will get kroshtur. So, kroshtur, then repha is there, that will take kharavasanayo visarjaniya, and then after this ratsasya, you will get kharavasanayo visarjaniya, repha will become, this sakara lopa has taken place, ratsasya, then this ur repha will become what? This ratsasya here. So, there is a sakara has undergone lopa here, and then this repha will become visarga, kharavasanayo visarjaniya. Okay, so what do you have? Kroshtuhu. So kroshtu is what? Kroshtu is a form in Panchami Ekvachana as well as Shashti Ekvachana. So both, in both you will get the same from kroshtuhu. And that is true with Dhatuhu Ityadi. Dhatuhu in Dhatru Shabda. So now what do you have? The next is optional Trijubhadbhava. Again, kroshtu, if it has become Rukaranta, then you will get what? In Osthana, kroshtoho, kroshtroho. So kroshtroho, Urandrapara will apply. Ikoyanchi will apply. After Ikoyanchi, you will get Kroshtros. Then Rutva Visarga will give you Kroshto, Kroshtroho. Difficult to pronounce. Jackal Shabda, most of our study was all based in non Kavya and non Sahitya. So it was all Vedanta basically. So in Vedanta, where are we going to see Kroshtru Shabda? So we all skipped this while studying. At least in our class, we skipped all this. Swami Shankaranji said this Kroshtru Shabda and all is not important, so I am going to skip it. So anyway, Laghukara considers this as a bridge between Ukara and Rukara. So Kroshtru ho, Kroshtru ho, Kroshtu Aam. So when Aam follows, Rasvanadhyapo Nut, then Vipratishyade Paramkaryam, thereby Vibhasha Tritiyadishu Achi. Now here there is a Vartika. Num Achira Trujvad Bhavebhyah Nut Purva Vipratishedena. What does it say? It is that Nut. By Purva Vipratisheda, this Nut will take precedence. Or what? Num. So either if Numagama is needed, this Achira is there, Trujvad Bhava, so what should happen? Nut should take place. So there is no possibility of the Numagama Ityadi applying or Trujvad Bhava. What will happen here? Here you will get Nudagama. So Numagama, if Num is Prapta, then it is Mit. Num is a Mit Agama, therefore Midachontyat Paraha will apply. If Nut applies, then Adyantav Takitav will apply. Therefore, Nakara coming in from Nut or Num can have different positions in the Sthani. So here what is happening? Kroshtu plus Aam, there will be Nudagama. So this Nud Adyantav Takitav, because Nut Purva Vipratishedena, thereby Naam, it will become Naam, it will Adyantav Takitav will apply, and then it will go to the Adi of the Aam Pratya, it will become Naam. Then Naami Achaha Angasya Dhirgha, Kroshtu will become Kroshtu, you will get Kroshtu Naam. So Kroshtu Naam is the Shashti Bahuvachana form. Then Ni Pratya Vibhasha Tritiyasu Achi. So Ni is E Pratya, content is here itself. The E is an Ach, therefore Achi what? Tritiyadishu Vibhasha. So you will get Trujvat Bhava. So U will become Ru, Kroshtu will become Kroshtru, then Ruto Ni Sarvanamasthanayo Angasya Gunaha, thereby A, Kroshtu will become A, then Urandrapara will give you this Repa. Urandrapara will give you, not here, Urandrapara should have been mentioned here. So A by Guna, then Angasya Guna, then Urandrapara will apply. Raparaha. Urandrapara will apply, and then you will get Rephayar Kroshtari. Then you will get Kroshtari. Pakshe Haladavcha Shambhuvat. So wherever there is Tritiyadishu Achi applying, when you have not applied that, as in taken this Vibhasha of Trijanta, then it will remain Ukaranta, and then it will decline like Shambhu or Guru. So what are the Vibhasha Sthanas? You look at this Ajadi Pratyat Tritiyadishu. So here Vibhashas, these are not Ajadi, so there is no Vibhasha here. Here there are two forms, then all two forms here, then O sthana, you'll get two forms. Then here this aam pratyaya has become naam, therefore only single form. This is nut has taken place here. Here anyway su pratyaya is there, but e pratyaya being there, two forms. So wherever there is ajadi pratyaya following in the tritiyadi sthana, one will be like guru or shambhu, the other will be like dhatru ityadi trijanta form. Okay, so that then hu. So here hu is again a rare word. I'm going to skip this. There is not much sutras anyway. No sutras applying here. So just look at the forms if you're interested. Then atichamu. Atichamu is one who wins over the chamu. Chamu is an army. So one who wins over the other army is called an atichamu. So atichamu is a pullinga shabda. Now atichamu, how it is derived is mentioned. Then what happens here? It is a samasa, right? Atichamu is a tatpurusha samasa. Atikrantha senam chamum senam atikrantha iti atichamu. So then being a samasa, it will get pratipadika sanya, and then it can take suadu ityadi pratyas atichamuhu. So rutva visarga will give you atichamuhu. That's all applying there. Then atichamu shabdetu nadikaryam visheshaha. So nadikaryam is there. So it takes nadi ukaranta, therefore yustriakyo nadhi, there this nadi shabda by ambartha nadyur haswaha sambuddhau eng raswat sambuddhe, these will apply, and then in sambuddhi you will get atichamu. He atichamu atichamve by an nadyaha nityangat atascha ikoyanachi. So ikoyanachi will apply and you will get atichamve. There is a an nadyaha will give you vriddhi. So an nadyaha, there will be vriddhi, atascha vriddhi, ai it will become, and ikoyanachi by atichamv, you will get atichamv, but then atichamv varnam yelam with aikara, you will get atichamvai. Atichamvai chaturthi ekvachana, atichamvai namaha, whatever, atichamvaha. So ikoyanachi, nothing else here, basically yangonga is not going to apply, so you will just get ikoyanachi, and whatever is the between pratyaya and aadagama, whatever is the karya vriddhi will take place. If aad comes in, then vriddhi takes place, that's all. In aam sthana, what will happen? Nud will come in, and adyanto takito will make the aam naam, then nami angasya dirgha atichamu, it is parjanyavat, already dirgha, so atichamu remains atichamu, so dirgha is parjanyavat. Parjanyavat. There is no karya, it has to be applied because it is prapta, but ukara becoming dirgha will make it ukara itself. Then khalapuhu. Khalapu is a cleaner. One who khala is bhumi, one who cleans the bhumi, punati iti, cleans is called as khalapuhu. So ukaranta pullinga. What happens here? So derivation is given, how it is derived. So upapada tatpurusha, you will get khalapu, then rutva visarga will be khalapuhu, then khalapu plus au. What will happen here? Achishnu dhatu bruam is prapta. Dhatu avayava uvarna. Uvarna is mentioned, so ati achishnu dhatu bhuvam yor iyang uvamo is prapta, but next sutra is introduced as an apvada. So khalapu plus au, there it is a dhatu. Pu is a dhatu, ukaranta dhatu. So shnu dhatu bhuvam, so dhatu has been mentioned, therefore due to this dhatu, after a dhatu which is what? Uvarna ending dhatu avayava uvarna is there. This pu ukara is a uvarna which is dhatu avayava, therefore achishnu dhatu bhuvam yor iyang uvang is prapta, which is prapta uvang adesha, not iyang, uvang is prapta, not yan. So that is negated by the next vidhi sutra, which is osupi. Osupi what? Anekacha asanyoga purvasya angasya yan dhato achi. So much is there. So what is the sutra saying? We have seen ehe anekacha ityadi. So ehe anekacha asanyoga purvasya yan, all this is from that sutra. So that we already know. What does it say? Yan is the adesha for what? When there is no sanyoga, asanyoga purva anga, which is also what? Anekacha anga, and what? Dhatu. Now here specifically dhato is also there, so it should be dhatu anga. And it should be ending with uvarna. So now do we have that in khalapuhu? Khalapu shabda, this punj dhatu is there, therefore punj pavane, that pu dhatu is dhatu, condition is met. Is it uvarna? Yes, ending with ukara, therefore uvarna ending is there. Is there a sanyoga before this ukara? No, only pakara is there, therefore no sanyoga is met. Is it aneka? Yes, kha, la, pu, three achs are there, therefore it is anekaj. So anekajanga dhatu, no sanyoga, uvarna is met. Now what ach sup should be following? Achi supi, supi is mentioned, and achi, achi supi. So ajadi supi, supi pratyay pare, that's what it will mean. So ajadi is a, is an ajadi following, where what are we deriving? We are deriving khalapu plus au, so au is ajadi, so ajadi is also met. Achi supi is, achi supi, condition is met here, achi supi. So achi supi is also met. Now we have achi supi and all these earlier conditions are met. Achi supi is also met because au is a supratya and it is also an ajadi pratya. So what will happen? Yand will be the adesha uvarna. What was prapta? Uvang was prapta. Instead of uvang, you will get yand. Thereby what will happen? The form will be khalpau. Khalpau will be the form, and similarly khalpa ityadi. So all that we have seen is either you will get iyang or yakara in ivarna kind of a situation. In uvarna kind of a situation, either you will get uva or you will get vakara by yan. So here vakara is prapta by yan. Ev sulu adayaha. Similarly, what sulu? Sulu is shushtu lunati iti sulu. One who cuts well will be called a sulu, and then it will also decline in the same manner, meaning what? It will also get yan. Because lu, the dhatu lunj there, the dhatu will be there, lunati, sulu, lu. So lunj is also what? It's a dhatu. Ukara will be the dhatu anga ending with uvarna, and also will be lakara purva, which is asanyuga purva. Therefore, all that will cause yan to take place. Then what about swabhuhu? Swabhuhu, so here what happens in swabhuhu? The swasmad bhavati swabhuhu, one who is born from himself, meaning born of himself, there is no karana. Akarana, one who is has karana rahita, karana, who is karana for others, ishvara, who is karana rahita. So you can say just karana rahita, one who is, that is called as swabhuhu. Elsewhere it is called as swayambhu. So swayambhu, we have these murtis which are swayambhu. So similarly swabhu also has the same meaning. So bhu sattayam plus swapurvaka bhu sattayam quip, then you will get swabhu. Then supo dhatu pratipadiko look way apruktasya, this quip vakara will go away, it is a zero pratyaya swabhu. So swabhu plus su, it is a pratipadika now. Hal nyapyo dirghasutisya pruktam hal lupyate lopaha. So swabhu rutto visarga, rutto visarga will apply kharavasanayor visarjaniya. Before that sasajusho ru, so rutto is this 8 to 66 is what? It is sasojushoru, and 8315 is kharavasani or visarjaniya. It will be marked as rutto visargau in laghu elsewhere. Swabhu, so you will get swabhuvau. Then here what has happened? Achishnu dhatu ruvam uvang adesha has taken place. Your iyang uvangau, so e varna and u varna endings will get what? Iyang and uvang respectively. Here you have u varna ending, therefore it will take uvang. Why here? We have dhatu. So we have a dhatu, atishnu dhatu bhuvam. So thereby ukara is called bhakara, and but it is what? It is achishnu, achi, ach pratyay is following, so achi is also met, dhatu condition is met. Yoho uvarna, uvarna is met, so yoho is met, so uvang adesha is will apply. What has happened? Iko yanachi was prapta, but negated by purva savarna dirga, prathamayo purva savarna. Then dirgha jasi cha, again there is guna prapta there. Then uvang is prapta by achishnu dhatu, which is negated by yan. So so much is happening. Yan by what? Os supi. Finally yan is also negated by nabhu sudhiyo. Why? Because nabhu sudhiyo, and then what will happen? Again it will go back to uvang by what? Achishnu dhatu bruvang. Why? Because we have seen sudhi earlier. Now this bhu part is covered here, bhu. So bhu dhatu is there. So thereby see so much has happened. Iko yanachi, first prapta, negated by prathameva purva savarna dirgha. Dirgha is Dirgha is refuting, negating this yand which is prapta. Then that is negated Dirgha jasicha. I think here there is what guna. So that is also negated by uvam, by what? Achishnu dhatu ruvam, your young vangu. Now this, hold on to this. He says, okay, this is, before applying this, osupi is negating yand. So, which is negated by yand, osupi is negating this uvang by yand. So brings in yand again, osupi. So now here what is happening, this yand is also negated by what? Na bhusudhiyo. So if it is negated, then where it should go? It will go back to uvang. So it will go to uvang adeshava achishnu. So it is not that directly achishnu dhatu ruvam is applied, but you have to go through the entire sequence and then come back. So this is a complicated section as I mentioned. But what is the difference? The most of the times either you will see yan applying or you will see yang uang applying. That is the difference. So you have to look at what is the sequence. That sequence is complicated, but the results are simple. Either it is yan or it is yang or uang. So you will get swabhuaha. Uang adesha will give u. So ukara is replaced by uva, and then you will get uvanga desha will give uva swa bhuvaha. So that is the form there in prathama bhuvachana. And so on, you see, there is no yand here. It is all uvaha, 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 uvam. Then uva, uve, uvaha. Then uoho. Wherever ajadi follows, uoho, uvam, uvi. These are the places you all see uva there. Not at all yand. Then what? Varshabhu. Varshasu bhavatiti varshabhu. So one who is, or that which is born in rains is called as varshabhu. Ukaranta. How it is derived is mentioned. It is an upapada tatpurusha pratipadika sanya by samasa. Kurtadhi samasa cha pratipadikam samasa sanya. Then again what is happening if you look at it. Here you see bhauhu. So you see bhauhu, bhaha, bham, bha, dve, bha, bha, bhoho, vi, vam also. What is happening? Not yang uvang. What has happened here? Here you have got yand. So what is happening here? Anadi. So it is anadi. So bhu sudhiyo ho. Right? But you cannot actually, again, same problem. This entire thing is wrong here. It should go after the sutra. So we expect, here also we expect, because na bhu sudhiyo ho, na bhu sudhiyo will negate yan, yan na bhavati, then it will go back to achishnu dhatu ruvam and should have given you uvam. But what is happening? Na bhu sudhiyo ho is further negated by varshavascha yan achisupi. So varshavascha, varshavascha says what? Varshabhu, after a varsha, this varshabhu shashti, ekvachana varshavascha. Here itself you see yand has been used. In Shashti Ekvachana, yand has been used. That word itself has used yand sandhi. So after a varshabhu shabda, ajadi, achi supi, ajadav supi pratyay pare, yand is brought back. So you get yanadesha and you will not get uvangadesha. So you will get what? Varshabhu ityadi. So specific mention of a shabda as to varshabhu itself. It is a specific negation of na bhusudhiyoho. Then what? Drunhu. So drun bhavate prapnoti iti drubhu. This bhavate, I do not know what this. So bhavate, what this is, I am not sure. So prapnoti, some other dhatu maybe, bhavate. So one who gains himsa, what I mentioned, drubhu. So a particular king or whatever. Sun snake, so many meanings are given. Drunbu. Vartika is a drunkara punaf purvasya bhuo yan vaktavya. So some particular vartika says yan vaktavya. So drunbu, drunkara punaha purvasya. So here what is a drunkara punaha purvasya? So drun is preceding bhua. So bhu dhatu, which is preceded by drun kara punaha ityadi, that should not ityadi, those words are there. Those, in that case, yan should be ordained. Then what will happen? Yan will take place instead of uvangadesha. So here na bhusudhiyo, bhu dhatu is there, definitely na bhusudhiyo yan. So yan na bhavati, bhusudhiyo yan na bhavati, uvang was ordained But now, bhu, which has a drun purva, by the vartika, drun is there. Therefore, what? Yan vaktavyaha. Yan will be the adesha. Uvam will not be there. And yan will be, although bhu should not take yan, it will take yan because of the vartika. And then you, similarly, karabhu ityadi. So it will get karabhoho ityadi forms will be there. Karabhu ityadi. Now he has landed on rukaranta, dhatru shabda. Instead of kartru dhatru that we study, dhatru shabda. So dha plus truch. Nul truchau. What will you get? Tachila tadharo tatsadukarishu. Trun or truch. So truch or trun will give you rukaranta dhatrupada. Meaning what? This dha is to. See, you get vi purvaka dha, you will have heard the word vidhata. So ishvara. So dharana poshana karta. Dharana poshana karta dha. Dhatu is in that sense, therefore dharana posha kartra, karta is dhatru. How it will decline? We have seen the form of kroshta, so similarly dhata. What is happening? This aptruntrich, this will apply this trunanta or trujanta and rukaranta. So here you will get what? An will be the adisha, dhatru, ru. You start with ru itself, not u like kroshtu. So trujanta, tru shabda, it will take anadesha by this anang adesha. So रुदुशनस पुरुदंसो अनहसांच अनंसौ असंबुद्धौ एंड विथ ङिच्च अलोन्त्यस्य सो थ्रू विल बी रिप्लेस बाय अन ओनली लास्ट लेटर रू विल बी रिप्लेस बाय अन नॉट थ्रू रू विल बी रिप्लेस बाय अन यू विल गेट धातन एंड धातन देन देर इज उपदाय दीर्घ बाय अप्तृ इत्यादि यू विल गेट धातान धातान प्लस हल्याभ्यो दीर्घा सुतिस्य प्रोक्तम लोपः सो हल लोपः But halnyabhyo, this hal is coming into play after and hal, halbhyaha, halnyabhyaha, there hal in panchami there will be what? Halaha. So halaha, dirghat is not coming into place. Sutisi, in this what is coming into play? Su is coming into play. So su, hal, after halaha, su, hal lopaha, hal lupyate. The hal, after a hal ending pratipadika, this su, Hal will go away. Sakara will go away. So Sakara goes away. And then you are left with Dhatan. And this Dhatan, Nalop of Pratipadika. So Nakara, which is at the beginning of the Pratipadika, as well as at the end of the, not the beginning, end of the Pratipadika and the end of the Pada will undergo Lopa. So Supting Antam Padam will give you Padasanya. Then Nalop of Pratipadika Antasya Padantasya. Then you will get Dhata. So Dhata is Prathama Ekvachana. Then Sambodhana He Dhataha. How? Dhatru plus Su in Sambodhana Prathama will give you Ruto Ni Sarvanamasthane Angasya Gunaha. Then Urandrapara Ru will become A. Then Urandrapara will give you this Repha. So you will get Dhatar. Dhatar plus Sa again Hal after and Hal. This Su Hal will undergo Lopa by Halnyabhyo Dirga Sutisya Pruktam Hal. Lopaha Lupyate. So you will get Dhatar. Then Kharavasanayur Visarjaniya. Raha padasya. So this padanta repha will become visarga he dhataha is sambodhana prathama. Dhataru, just same thing put together, you will get dhataru dhataraha. Then there is a vartika which says what? Ruvarnat nasya natvam vachyam. There should be natvam. Because of Ru, this Rashabhyam Nodha Samanapade does not mention Ruvarna. Dvartika mention is, so basically Natvam. So you get Dhatru Naam, Aam in the, and Aam follows, Nudagama comes in, Aam becomes Naam. Then Nami Dirgaha Dhatru, Ru will become Ru Dirgaha. And then this Nakara will take Natvam by the Rashabhyam Nodha Samanapade. Then Ruvarnam Nasya Natvam Vachyam. Thereby you get Dhatru Naam. And that is the end of Dhatu Shabda, Evam Naptru Adaya. Similarly, Naptru, Napta, Naptaro, Naptara, grandson, that's how it will decline. The Trujan Trun Anta will have a Rukaranta. The Pitru Shabda, Pitru Shabda is a little different, so we'll see in the next part. Natavasane Nataraja Rajo Nana Dhatakam Navapanchavaram उद्धर तो काम सनकादि सिद्धान एतद् विमर्शे शिव सूत्र जालम नमस्ते धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद है।